Save the Ninja Clan is a new game from the same developers as Energy Cycle. You know, it's that 15-minute puzzle game that you can literally complete without looking at the screen. Like Energy Cycle, it comes at a very affordable price, and, well, that's where the similarities end. It's a game that offers an altogether different experience from this developer, and it's really pretty decent. I'm Kevin with the TrueGaming Network, and this is my first impression of Save the Ninja Clan. So this is a platformer, and it's pretty simple. You're a ninja, and you can throw blades, and you can jump high. It's pretty par for the course. Each level is very short, and you'll go through them quickly as you progress through the game. Gameplay never really gets interesting, but each level does have a different little challenge and gameplay trick that you'll need to figure out to get through the mission. That's the core of Save the Ninja Clan's gameplay. If you start a level, you die, you try again, you die, and you keep doing that until you figure out what it is the level is actually challenging you to do. It's usually pretty simple, and this works well enough. The levels aren't long, so dying isn't the worst thing in the world, and that's a good thing since you'll definitely be dying a lot. That said, I do think that some of these levels are a tad too long for this type of gameplay. Some of them can easily take close to a minute, and I think ideally they would have been around 10 or 20 seconds each. Still, what's here works, and it's fun. The achievements are thankfully pretty easy, and the site estimate sits at a very comfortable 4 hours. There's nothing too hard here, and if you ever get stuck, it'll be easy to look for a guide to figure out what's missing. You can even do neat little things like complete a level with reverse controls, which I had a lot of fun doing. The achievements are interesting, and they will keep you engaged for the full completion. I should note that they do come in variables of 3, not 5, so you'll get some uneven gamer score here. But since that game is short and it's pretty easy, there shouldn't be much of a problem with that. You'll easily be able to get back to that solid 1000. Overall, I like this game. It's very decent. There's definitely better games of this type out there, but for the price and the completion time, it's hard to beat Save the Ninja Clan. If you're trying to find that one excellent platformer to play, this game, well, it wasn't made for you. But if you just want to have a bit of fun with a quick completion, well, you come to the right place. I'm Kevin with the TrueGaming Network, and this has been my first impression of Save the Ninja Clan. If you enjoyed this video, please like it. We really appreciate it. And for more first impressions, all you gotta do is subscribe. Until next time, everyone.